Ciao, vita compañeros y bienvenidos. Today we are on a mission to find out how quick you can hack your PS Vita and install and play Grand Theft Auto San Andreas in 2023. So, let's get cracking. First, the disclaimer, this is not a tutorial. Clearly, we are adhering to community guidelines. I do not encourage you to do anything. This is purely an experiment. I have done similar video last year in 2022, link in the right corner. But the methods have changed. They are now more efficient, more quicker, and we want to know exactly how easy and how quick they are. So let's boot up the Vita. As a preparation, I have my Vita connected to Wi-Fi with some free storage available. Then I have also all the necessary files on my PC ready to go. That's it, and now let's begin with the hack first. Stopwatch ready, set, go! Open Vita browser. Type in the web address, click unlock my Vita and unlock again, and voila, job done. Vita is hacked in about 34 seconds. New handlock method is amazing and it couldn't be any easier. Step 2, install Vita Deploy from the bootstrap menu, then enable unsafe homebrewing settings, open Vita Deploy, go to app downloader, check Vita shell and press download. It will also install it. We need it cause we wanna connect Vita to the PC and transfer necessary files. I forgot to measure these steps, but it took me roughly 3 minutes, so I'm giving myself 3 minutes penalty. Step 3, now on the PC, transfer 2 VPKs. One is Auto Plugin 2 and one is Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. And then we need also the data files for San Andreas. They're about 2.6 GB and it took about 7 minutes to transfer them. Stopwatch are still running, I will fast forward it, and now we are done. Files are there, and now we are back on the PS Vita. We need to install both VPKs. For necessary plugins, I'm using Auto Plugin 2. For correct usage of this app, I'm including video I've made about it in the right corner. So first plugin we need is FDFix. Second plugin is Kubridge. And third is Shader Compiler. For Shader Compiler, you need to install SharkBrit app. That will do all the procedures automatically. So you just run it and it will download and install first PlayStation Mobile Runtime Package and then SharkFood app. So close Auto Plugin 2, reboot, run SharkBrit. To check if Shader Compiler procedure was successful, I'm going into UR0/data folder and the plugin needs to be there. And it is, so we can proceed to finally launching Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. And I'm happy to announce that we did it! Mission is successful! Time on the clock is 16 minutes 47 seconds. I just went quickly to the settings to turn off annoying AVLS feature, cause we wanna have proper immersive experience. Now we are back in game with AVLS turned off. 18 minutes 46 seconds. Quick overclock and we can enjoy this groundbreaking PS Vita port of San Andreas. Now to the conclusion. It's never been easier to hack PS Vita than with new revolutionary handlock exploit. Anybody can do it, no need for PC or PSN account. Wi-Fi is all you need. In my opinion, every single PS Vita deserves to be modded in 2023, cause there is so much benefit in doing so and downsides, none. Compared to the 2022 video I've made, I said it took me roughly 1 hour to do it in there, and now it's about 20 minutes. So it is indeed a revolutionary method. Obviously afterwards you would want to also install Enzo SD2 Vita. If you are looking for inspiration, type into the YouTube search bar Zeloschak PS Vita, and I'm sure there is something for everyone. If you haven't seen my latest video about the young brother of PSP Go, RK2023, check it out right here. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like. Subscribe, join. Thanks to you for watching. Thanks to devs for always improving. Thanks to members for support. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.